4 years of our work to pull together the latest advanced technologies, really combine them with evolution and some fundamentals, the foundational technologies, and stay true to the ethos of the original NSX. So I'm a chief engineer and large project leader of a global team. The powertrain technologies, engine, transmission, three motors, battery, and power electronics were all developed in Japan. So on the other side of the Pacific Ocean, running 24/7, are all those components in a large room on a bench. And here, we have the physical representation of those components connected as a full vehicle with Nick, Jason, and Nate, everyone really evolving and integrating all these technologies. So that just gives you a flavor of our global team. I'm going to go ahead and try to do all this in about 30 minutes, so stick with me, and then Gary will join us and talk about product planning. So this first slide is our next generation concept. And so this foundation or plane is trying to draw out the original NSX and how it approached technology. So NSX stands for New Sports Experimental, experimenting with technologies to provide new value in an existing crowded space. So it's a difficult concept in and of itself. On the axis going to the right, really focused on driver-centric cockpit. If you can support the driver, you can slow down the events around them and have them focus on driving. So we focus very much on visibility, a very simple and ergonomic interface, and we focused on supporting you in the cabin, but still allowing freedom of motion, especially in your upper torso. Peak performance is a result and an outcome, and it's certainly wonderful. And then on this case, we've just evolved NSX to New Sports Experience. So here we're trying to, again, experiment with technologies and provide a new driving experience. But we're starting, please don't misunderstand, this is a sports car at its core. So having that performance accessible to you, having the driver at the center of it all. And if the driver only has to focus on throttle, brake, and steering, here we're trying to focus on those elements. So certainly the acceleration, which you know, minimizes the delay, it's very linear, it's continuous. Your steering inputs are faithfully and precisely translated into your desired line trace as you search ahead with your eyes, looking for the apex. And then certainly as you head out to the roads, the wide range of performance that this vehicle can offer through a very kind of simplistic and elegant dynamic mode switch. So we're going to go through those. Those are the elements of the new sports experience in our minds as we develop this product. So here again, if you start at the bottom and evolve up, we have some of the competitors that we tasted and tested. This is not a benchmarking activity. Early on in the project, we met with the original NSX team, drove the original NSX as we drove these other fine, amazing products, and realized very early on, just like the first generation NSX, we have to have our own intention. We have our own space in this market, but we do have these vehicles here for reference. NSX DNA, of course, power to weight ratio, we're gonna get to that when we move up, but we already talked about the driver-centric cockpit. The way in which the suspension supports the unsprung mass, but also supports the driver, I think that's a hallmark feature of the original NSX, the way in which it flows across the road, but also doesn't upset you, the driver in the seat. Peak performance, as I said, is an outcome, especially lap time. And our car will lay down some serious lap times, especially having some of the highest cornering speeds we've ever seen. And then the new sports experience is something that emerges. And so there again, direct and linear acceleration. In terms of steering, the line trace, and this will be out on the public road, we separated the steering in terms of up to 0.7 lateral G, really linearizing that range. That will be appreciated on the road, I hope. And today you had a feeling of the higher capacity cornering from 0.7 G up in excess of 1 G. The brake response for us, trying to provide a very faithful, powerful brake system, that you can access that be precise in the real road will be even more of a challenge for any system. And we talk about the wide range of experiences, and this doesn't always play depending on your viewpoint, but the option to fly under the radar when you want to in quiet mode for us is really worthwhile as an evolution of sports cars. So let's start with some of the fundamentals, just the package. So package is all about moving the components down low in the chassis, centering them up close to the driver. We're targeting a very specific weight distribution, 58-42, and a low center of mass means that as you are driving today, you're able to stabilize the load on those four tires. Moving forward, Jason Widmer walked around the exterior design last night. We're very proud of the fact that we really pumped up the emotional quality of the original show car design, showed in 2012. And then, of course, Jason walked you through last night the challenge to not only flow the air across the exterior surface, a full flat floor, but take the air through the front motor room, reattach it down the side of the vehicle, reintroduce that air into the rear motor room, and then manage all the airflow off the back of the vehicle. Very specific high speed aerodynamic balance. We wanted three times the downforce in the rear versus the front. Really just trying to find that sweet spot between downforce for stability, but also not too much downforce to steal peak performance. Visibility, as I mentioned, highlight of the first generation NSX. Here, there's a deep in the instrument cluster behind the center console. It's a very compact HVAC unit. You can't see it. It's really cool because it let us lower down the entire instrument panel. Of course, we have a very compact meter gauge and truncated at the top of the steering wheel. You can enjoy the blister fenders. The blister fenders are actually quite nice to point you down to the apex. An interesting guide. Not unlike a couple of tires on the formula car. But then we had a big challenge to minimize the A-pillar obstructed angle. And so you compare it to 25 years ago, there's global roof crush requirements and other requirements. So we did create or pull a brand new technology in order to meet the swoopy styling, the crazy curve to the styling, meet the roof crush standards and minimize the obstructed view. It's a three-dimensionally quenched and bent, we call 3D cube. It's a steel square section, and as it's heated and cooled, we are able to describe this precise arc. So it's very precisely done. The section is really no bigger than a quarter. So the NSX has superior forward visibility. Now stepping back more from a driver's point of view and trying to take in a very kind of simple driver interface, we take a decidedly different approach than some of the other vehicles. We're trying to minimize buttons. We say we should support the driver or get out of the way. So the seat, you'll notice the Alcantara is down the spine. This is not a Type R. This is not a GT3 Scuderia. So we kind of found that sweet spot. The Alcantara is very sticky, so it'll stick your body in the spine, but again, the perimeter gives you freedom of motion with the leather. You know, these hatched yellow areas where we're trying to support the driver, and if you go to the center section, the hatched yellow areas down low. So really, we feel you can lay your legs down on the dead pedal and close to the throttle and support your body in the seat in conjunction with the interior surfaces. And the steering wheel, hopefully you felt a nice comfortable grip, really worked to shape the steering wheel to maximize the contact surface with your hand. And we've eliminated the contrasting stitching. So we went with an invisible stitch. Again, just trying to not aggravate. A lot of that stitching really cuts you at the base of your thumb. So we thought that was not good for a performance-oriented view.